Hello, my name is Tony Dway, president of Vision Communications. Since 1980, local artists have graced the cover of our telephone directory. These works of art showcase not only their individual talents, but they showcase scenery and lifestyles that cannot be found anywhere else. While our Cajun culture may be slowly fading, these works of art provide moments frozen in time of our heritage that will remain forever. In this program, you will get to know the artist, learn how they discovered their talents, and what this area means to them. You will also meet a group of young artists that came together to create the 2011 cover, marking the most recent chapter in our history of directory artists. So sit back, relax, and enjoy as Vision Communications proudly presents Brushes with Time.
Back in the days when the phone company was first started, General Telephone provided the directories for us, and the directory at that time was a very small directory, green in color, and they also sold the advertising. Advertising is a way of raising money. The years passed and the directory became more lucrative, and different companies started vying for the ability to do the canvassing to sell our yellow pages. As competition came in, the companies kept raising their percentages until the point where they said they couldn't do any more. So they said, what else can we do to sweeten the pot? And I had seen at a national convention a specialized cover, which was different than the ordinary covers. And I suggested that maybe they could provide us a color cover. So we then started initially with plain photographs, and we came along with the idea, why don't we do something that will really highlight our area? And we worked with local artists to do that, L'Artiste de Bayou. And we had them paint a picture for us. And then from that, the directory company took a photo of it and imposed it upon our directory cover. In order to accomplish that, it was difficult because the artist had to create two focal points of interest, because the painting was going to be divided in half, one on the front side and one on the back. And it really became a challenge for them. Then in order to create a further challenge, I came up with the idea after the famous movie director, Alfred Hitchcock. It was Alfred Hitchcock. It was his habit to always have him included in every picture. One of the interesting things is when it got time to decide who was going to be the next painter of the cover, it didn't matter. We could have selected anyone because they were all so talented in that area. We took high school young adults. They're still in high school, and they painted covers for us. It really didn't matter, in the opinion of the rest of the world, who was the best, because in our opinion, they were all great. I think to myself.